Abhay Soi, the chairman and MD of Radiant Lifecare, joins us on the show right now. Abhay, hi, morning. When we look at the hospital sector, Abhay, there has been consolidation for the last three to four years, actually. Do you think this is a trend which is going to continue, where there will be large three, four players which are going to dominate the market and largely consolidate?
Well, that seems to be happening, but I think it's more of a generational change which is happening rather than consolidation so far. Yes, it will move towards consolidation, and this is perhaps because you know, the sector has had 2 weak years. Balance sheets of all the players may not be in the same position, as well as you know, in some cases there has been stress at you know, the promoter level and so on and so forth. That is something which is essentially led to consolidation in the sector. So I see some more single hospital plays and so on come into the fray going forward as well, you know, enabling and allowing an opportunity for consolidation. But you know, I don't think it's a proactive move towards consolidation, really. I think it's more of a generational change where we see some very lucrative and some very, very good assets come into play.
When we just look at consolidation, as you said, that lucrative assets are available, but size does get in a lot of benefit as well. You know, like, you know, after you have acquired recently some new hospitals, you've become sizable in North. So can you just tell us that what benefits come in once you get better sizes operating in different regions? How does that help for operating leverage?
So I see a lot of advantage when you get geographical concentration. So that gives you a lot of heft. Size per se across you know, geographies, in my mind, is not necessarily the best strategy, because you know, really where you get the two areas where you get a lot of synergy, one would be purchase and the other would be marketing. But the minute you start spreading it across geographies, you start losing that advantage as well. What does make sense is to have a geographical concentration, because, you know, it gives you an ability, closer to your market. You're able to provide various clinical programs and services at different price points, you know, so you can play across the spectrum.
So there are a lot of single hospitals in various areas that are trying to operate, but, you know, they would not get any of these benefits. Do you think that's the space which will consolidate more than multi-speciality chains?
So, of course, I think, you know, when it comes to single hospitals, again, you know, you're looking at primary care, you're looking at secondary, and then you're looking at quaternary care hospitals. What has happened is also over a period of time, you know, the size and scale of basic critical size required for a quaternary care hospital has changed. You know, what used to be about 150 to 200 beds in the past has moved to, you know, 500 plus beds, simply because of the comorbidities and you know, the kind of clinical programs that you require. Today, to have an oncology program in a hospital, you know, worth its while, you're going to have at least about 70 to 100 beds dedicated to it. To have a cardiac program, you will have another 70 to 100 beds dedicated to it. And then comes orthopedics, neuro, you know, various other specialties and so on and so forth. So, you know, given the infrastructure requirement for quaternary care in today's date and age, at least from India standpoint, just given the, you know, the quantum of people, the quantum of patients that we service, the minimum size, the critical size, comes to about 500 plus. So either you're a standalone hospital, which is, you know, going towards, you know, is providing the services that an institute does. Or if it's smaller hospitals of 200 to 300 beds, then it makes sense to become spokes to larger hospitals from that standpoint.
Right. You know, also, you know, one thing that when we spoke, we just spoke to the management at Bajaj General Insurance. They just told us that, you know, Mediclaim, the size of Mediclaim, the amount of people are insuring for Mediclaim has gone up. Can you just talk to us about Ayushman Bharat and this factor that Mediclaim people are aware that they need more? How is that impacting the volumes in the sector?
So I think two separate questions. Really, the level of penetration for you know, for Mediclaims, etc., you know, even so far in India, is fairly low. So there's a long way to go as far as that is concerned. What it is doing is, at the hospital level, it's replacing a lot of patients who are paying cash at present, or paying from their own pockets rather than insurance. So what we are seeing is the insurance pie enlarging, but it's doing it at the cost of the people who were cannibalizing the cash patients of the past. But as far as Ayushman Bharat is concerned, I mean, it's absolutely fantastic. The government has become the purchaser for the poorest in the country. Having said that, the bottom of the pyramid is the largest in terms of volumes, as it is anywhere in the world. Of course, it's a volume business. It's a huge volume business, albeit at a lower cost. So new models will come up which need to address this demand, but it will lead to massive volumes in the sector. No question about that.
What's your take on market share as well? Do you feel that's only going to come in on the back of the launch of new therapies or differentiating products? Anything else perhaps at hospitals? How do you feel, what is the route you feel for increasing market share?
So, in a developed economy, in developed countries and so on, market share does come on the back of newer therapies, because what you're again doing is eating into perhaps the more conventional forms of medicine and clinical programs. But in a country like ours, there is so underpenetration it's to such an extent that volumes don't necessarily have to come on the back of new therapies. It's just underserved and latent markets. If you just look at Ayushman Bharat, for that matter, it's just opened up a humongous part of the market which could not afford healthcare in the past. Today, the government is being able to pay for them, lower costs, but nevertheless, it's demand. So, from an Indian standpoint, I really don't think volumes is an issue. And, it has to come on the back of new therapies. Of course, new therapies will begin from a niche standpoint. And, at some point in time, it's going to roll out. It's going to expand its market share at the cost of conventional therapies. But nevertheless, I think conventional therapies, are here to stay for some time at least.
We spoke to the management at Apollo also just a while back, and also Fortis, the new management. Most of the managements are talking about capex and, being asset light and not being very, very heavy capex. They want utilizations to go up. They want their average revenue per bed to go up. And only then they would go ahead and, make new fresh capex with heavy investments. How do you see investments in the sector going in? On the backdrop of this M&A, a lot of people are preferring M&As to expand capacity rather than fresh investments.
So I think two things. It's pretty much what has happened in most sectors as well. Hospital sector has come off a very large capital expenditure cycle, and you can see a lot of the hospital chains did incur a lot of capital expenditure 4 to 5 years ago. And you saw a lot of capacity over the last 2 to 3 years which came in. Having said that, over the last 2 years, what has happened is the cycle, the sector has seen a downturn. And we are kind of inching back, to strong ground again, and pretty much there. But when you come off, when you come off weak economics, it just kind of shakes your confidence to be able to, create more assets. The economy is in a bit of a state right now. So I do see this changing over the next couple of years as RPOBs ramp up, as occupancies ramp up. Occupancies ramping up is a function of many things. You can occupy beds by lower category, patients as well. But as the churn happens, we move up to stronger ground. You will see another huge cycle of capex happening. I mean, we need to create those assets to be able to serve the demand.
Sure. Great having you on the show. Thank you so much for taking the time out and speaking with us today.
Pleasure always. Thank you.